Hi, and welcome to a midsummer night of Irish art. Myself and artist Doreen Burke have invited 9 other artists from all across Ireland to show some of their works and talk a little bit about them from wherever they are right now, either in their homes, their gardens, or their studios. I'm here beside my favourite tree right now. So thank you for tuning in, and we hope you enjoy the exhibition.
Hi there, my name is Aisling Hennessy. I am a Laois-based artist, and I'm here at the moment in the art house in Stradbally, where I currently have a studio, where I work on my paintings, and I work on my research also. So first up is this painting. It's called Twilight Bloom, and it is acrylic on canvas, and it's framed in a black bespoke frame, and it's a beautiful painting inspired by a digital piece that I had done last year, and its price is €225. Next up we have Eden. So this piece is also acrylic on canvas, and it was created last year. At the beginning of this year, and it's a beautiful piece with lots of depth. And finally, this piece is called Tauri, T-A-U-R-I, and it's another acrylic on canvas. It's a bit more surreal as opposed to kind of earth-based art, and very expressive, and the colours really kind of symbolise lots of vital energy and life force. So that's all. Really appreciate it. Sorry. So Eden's price is €400 and Tori's price is €325. Okay, thanks very much.
Hello, my name is Amy Gilfile. I'm also known as AGEG Artist. I'm an Irish artist based in Cork. I have exhibited my work nationally and internationally over the past few years, and today I am going to show you some of my abstract work that is inspired by nature. Okay guys, so this is the first abstract painting I'm going to be showing you today. This piece is titled Order Within Chaos, and the size is 51 centimeters by 71 centimeters. This piece is canvas with acrylic paint and was created using fingers, brushes, and a technique where I splash the paint all around the canvas to create the wild looking effect. This piece is inspired by nature, particularly the wind. So now I'm going to show you some close-up details of this piece, some of my favourite parts of it. There you go. Look. I just love how textured this piece is, and how the colours just blend in. This piece is 350 on framed, including postage, anywhere in Ireland. Okay, there we have it. And now we shall be moving on to the next piece. Okay, so this is our second piece, and this piece is titled Moonbeams and is 50.5 centimeters by 40.5 centimeters. This piece is canvas painting. This piece was created using watercolor paint and acrylic paint, and I used brushes and a palette knife to create the effect you see here. This piece is also inspired by nature, and now I'm going to show you some close-up details of this piece. As you can see, the black really brings out all the colors, makes them pop. This piece is 250 on framed and free postage anywhere in Ireland. Okay, and now we shall move on to the next piece. Okay, here is my next piece. This piece is titled Bubbles and is 30.5 centimeters by 41 centimeters. This is a canvas painting created using watercolor paint and acrylic paint. This is also a nature inspired piece. I'm going to show you some close up details of the piece now. As you can see, the tree branches and the light soft pastel colors. This piece is 220 with free postage anywhere in Ireland. Okay, now we shall move on to the next piece. Okay, this is my next piece, and this piece is titled Flower Drops. It is 30.5 centimeters by 41 centimeters, and this is an acrylic and watercolor painting. This painting is on canvas board and was created using a palette knife, brushes and fingers. And now I'm going to give you a close-up of this piece. As you can see, this is a slightly textured piece. So this piece is 200 unframed, free postage anywhere in Ireland. Okay, now we move on to the next one. Okay, so this is my next abstract piece, and this piece is titled Seabird. It is 26 centimeters by 35.5 centimeters. This is a painting on canvas, and it is watercolor acrylic inks. This was created using no brushes, when he's splashing the paint onto the canvas. And this piece was inspired by the sea, the waves, so I'm going to give you a close-up of it now. And this piece is 150 on framed, free postage anywhere in Ireland. Okay. Thank you for taking the time out to look at some of my abstract pieces today, and I hope you enjoyed.
Hi, my name is Donna Cairns, and I'm an illustrator and a painter from County Laois. A lot of my work is acrylic, ink and watercolour. I draw a lot of inspiration from mythology and learning about different world mythologies, and then I try to take my own spin, and I like to depict a lot of the characters from mythology. And another massive inspiration for me, you know, a lot of it centers around mental health themes, so it's kind of what I really like to paint. So I guess that's just a little bit about me. So now I'll show you the paintings that I've chosen to enter into the exhibition. These are the five paintings I have chosen to include in this exhibition. The first painting is called Fionnuala's Song, and it is inspired by the Irish legend, The Children of Lir, which was a story that my grandfather often told me when I was younger. This is acrylic on canvas, and this painting is €120. The next painting is also inspired by mythology, this time Norse mythology, and is a depiction of a Valkyrie. This painting is also acrylic on canvas and will also be €120. The next painting is called Ashes, and this painting is about stress and anxiety. This painting is also acrylic on canvas and is €100. The next painting is called Apathy and is inspired by hiding your emotions to protect those you love. This is also acrylic on canvas and is €60. And then lastly, this piece is titled The Lovers and is inspired by the relationship between life and death. This painting is acrylic and enamel, and the enamel is a metallic, so in the light it shines. And this piece is €50. So again, these are the five pieces I have chosen to include.
Hello, I'm James Devlin. I like to paint and draw. I've been doing it for about 6 years now. It's hard to talk about artwork, especially my own work. And sometimes it's hard to talk, but I'm gonna try anyway to take you through five pieces that I hope you'll enjoy. This painting came out of a series of sketches I did 3 years ago. Beautiful models with broken faces who are wearing clothes yet their breasts are exposed. Not much more I can say about it than that. This piece showed in Berlin. It's called Silk. Ah, it's amazing what you can pull out of a skip these days. In about 2014, I attended a nude life drawing session at Sol Art Gallery. I brought some marker pens and three paper bags. Two of the bags I got framed. This is one I got framed. I don't know what happened to the third one. This piece is called Drawn on a Brown Paper Bag. When I first started painting, I listened to a lot of jazz and blues music. It really helped with the work. So I decided to draw many of the artists that inspired me in a series called Dead Ink. This is a triptych. It showed in New York. I miss New York. King Kong. I've always loved how that sounded. I've titled a lot of my drawings King Kong. Here's a painting with the same title. It shows King Kong's silhouette and the Statue of Liberty. I always felt like King Kong should have climbed the Statue of Liberty instead of the Empire State Building. I don't really like the movies. I just love the words. King Kong. Love how that sounds. Try to work intuitively. too much to think and ruin a piece for me. I like to draw hands and feet because they're expressive, odd looking, kind of ugly and beautiful at the same time. Just fun to draw. This piece has a lot in it. Life, new life, comets, stars, hands, feet, dimension warp. What more could you want in a painting? It's blue, it's got tadpoles.
Hi there, my name is Doreen Burke and I live in Port Leash, County Leash, Ireland, and I am a mixed media artist. I specialise in resin and glass painting. I'd like to welcome you all here this evening for my part of this exhibition on this Midsummer's weekend. I like to call my art Embedded Ireland. I like to get inspiration from my surroundings like most artists. And I try and represent the elements and the things that make up Ireland. I hope you enjoy my work, but before you get there, I have to apologise. While I was filming, I filmed outside, and the neighbour's dogs decided to bark in celebration of my work. This piece is called The Acorns. It's made with resin, using real acorns, Swarovski pearls, 24 karat gold dust. It measures 17 inches by 15 and it's 200 euros. This piece is called The Ship in Forecast. It is resin and 24 karat gold dust. The story behind the title is because when I was making it, I was listening to the shipping forecast. And it turned out to be like the world. It has all lines through it, showing the shipping lines. It was a fun piece to make. This is 300 euros. This is my Midsummer's piece. It measures 2 foot by 1 foot, and it is made using resin, purple, green and blue, beech nuts from Emo Court in County Leash, and has 24 karat gold dust and copper dust. It is 300 euros. This piece is based on the Boglands. It's 17 inches by 15. It's resin with 24 karat gold dust. The greens and the golds and mustards of the bog. It's 200 euros. This is a room divider. It's painted matte black and the flower is painted using glass paint. It is 5 foot 11 inches tall and each panel is 1 foot 3 inches wide and there is 5 of them. big piece. And it's 1,200 euros.
Hi, I'm Egolona. I'm an Italian painter based in Dublin. My art is a mix of different techniques and styles that can be described as abstract figuration. It combines all my experiences and experiments of art practice, like fluid art, life drawing, portrait painting, screen printing, digital photography, mixed media so far. My art is a bit like the mirror of my personality, as I don't like to conform to a single archetype. I've selected 5 works for you to view. Each painting tells a little story. Let me show you around.
This is my latest painting, Speranza. Speranza is an Italian word. It means hope. I've used the symbolism of the butterfly to represent transformation and life. There is a message of hope here. Hope and the ability to go through important changes in life with grace and lightness. It's an oil on canvas, 60 by 60 centimeters, and the cost is 300 euros. This is called Tessellate. It's an acrylics on canvas. This painting comes from my blue moment. It was made during a period where all I painted was blue with this many shades. The price is 200 euros and it's 80 by 60 centimeters. This is Aerial Games, oil colors, acrylics and spray paint on canvas. It's inspired by an official video of Song from Band of Horses, and it's about endurance and balance. It's 50 by 40 centimeters and the price is 100 euros. This is probably one of my favorite abstract fluid art paintings that I've made. It's made on vinyl record and acrylic colors and pieces of mirror. It's pure abstraction and it resembles another galaxy far away, as seen from a satellite. It's 50 by 40 centimeters on canvas and the price is 150 euros. This is Doodles from the Heart. It's a very colorful painting. The doodles are not all abstract. There are swan references to the children of Lear. And it's all about transformation and the choices that one has to make with a heart. The cost is 150 euros and it's an acrylic on canvas, 50 by 40 centimeters. I hope you have enjoyed my gallery and feel free to follow me on Instagram at Egoluna Art to see more of my paintings.
Hi, my name is Owen DeForge. I'm a figurative painter from Dublin. I paint paintings of people because I like people and they're cool. And I like shapes and colors. So the first painting I'm going to show is from a series I'm working on at the moment, and then I'll show 4 others from the last few years. So I thought to myself, I was like, hey, what's up with rectangles? Why are they just everywhere all the time? I don't know, there's nothing wrong with them, but I was like, maybe it would be cool if it wasn't a rectangle, and we just kind of went loosey-goosey with it. So this is my attempt at being loosey-goosey. I really find that the non-rectangularity just allows you to really push the shapes for their maximum emotionalness. And realism's really not so much of an issue here, and you can go for like a heightened colors, heightened shapes. It's a lot of fun. This is a painting from 2018 that was shown in the RHA annual exhibition of that year. I really went to town on the face and the couch in this one, but I kind of liked letting the background just be a bit loose.
has a nice sort of watery texture to it that I enjoy. What I really like the most about this piece is the variety of textures. So you see in the face, I used some very thick brush strokes and impasto. And in other places, you can see the canvas shine through with some very watery application of paint.
I like Goya's black paintings a lot.
This is a plant study that I painted in San Diego, California. I really experimented with some brighter colors than I was used to. I was very interested in the type of succulent plants that they have there that were pretty unfamiliar for me at the time. This self-portrait was a lot of fun for me. It was different for me because I painted it all from life. I had to use my left hand, which was my bad hand. As you can see, my right hand was out of commission at the time. And I think I managed to capture the pain.
Thank you for watching. Thanks, Rebecca, for having me be a part of this. I hope you all enjoyed. Bye!
Hi, my name is Polly McAvoy. I'm a leash artist. Just first of all, I'd say thank you to Rebecca Deegan for inviting me to take part in this exhibition. Virtual, I've never done anything like this, and I'm not particularly comfortable in front of the camera. I'm co-owner of Heyday Studios with my friend Kira Drennan, who's a photographer. I'm, I suppose, like the resident artist. I do my own paintings there. I teach art and generally chief bottle washer. Can't wait for the studios to open again. Really, really missing them. So I suppose I've always painted and never really particularly fit into any category, nor do I really care about that. Today what I've done is grouped a couple of my paintings together, a few of my paintings together into, I suppose, two collections that that are close to my heart at the moment. And that's what I'm going to share with you as best I can from the gallery that is my kitchen at the moment, because I suppose that's the way it rolls in lockdown. Best luck to everyone who's taken part and to everyone for organising it. I just think it's a great idea, and thank you for the opportunity. So these are three of part of the collection that I call my Donna collection. I'll show you up close in a second, but Donna being the Irish word for colours is something that I'm very interested in. Love playing around with colour and just making art that is just can give a pop of colour to any room, basically. This first one over here is 90 by 90 centimeters, splash of colour. As you can see up close, there's lots of detail in all the little sections, and it's just something that I love getting lost in and doing. The next piece in the Donna collection is actually just here on an easel, and again, this probably is inspired by stained glass. I love that comparison between the dark line and the really, really bright colours. And again, there's quite a lot of detail when you zoom in as well. Great fun to do these, and they're very popular with people for, again, just adding a big pop of colour to a room. And the final piece that I'm going to show you in the Donna collection is this one. I also love trees, so this is bringing my two loves together of trees and colour, and I also love impressionist art, so there's lots of dots and dabs, and I don't really have a steady hand. That's basically it, three from the Donna collection. and I'm hoping to add more and more to this collection as time goes by. So the next little mini collection I'm going to show you is what I would call my sense of place collection. I'm fascinated by places and how they form part of our identity. We all have places that become our favourites. I do these a lot for commission work, where people send me a photograph of their favourite place or a place that's important. This was a recent one. It's of Howth Head with the Bailey Lighthouse. So again, I've probably used a lot of colour in that as well, which is what I usually revert to. Here is Emo Court. This is one close to my own heart. Again, taken from a photograph, or painted from a photograph. Just one day when I was out there and I just caught a glimpse of Emo Court between the trees, and I just thought it was really pretty. Final piece here then is the Round Tower in Timahoe, and also a very, I suppose, famous leash place. I enjoy doing these. Again, I probably take a bit of artistic license. But the colour, I'm not too sure the sky was that colour in Timahoe any day, but I just love playing around with the colour. That's pretty much it. This particular piece here, which is another piece that I've done recently, is actually sold, and it was inspired by my love of Monet and his work. So listen, thank you very much, and again thanks to Rebecca for allowing me to show these. Thanks a million. Bye.
Hi, my name is Polly Hogan, and today I'm going to be showing you a few pieces that I created over the last few months based under the theme of Midsummers. So the first piece I created is these three painting scatters. So first of all, I put in masking tape around each one just to kind of give it a clean edge. And then I added in, first this is like an evening kind of scene. So I put in the trees on the bottom and then kind of trees here, but not as dark, so these ones are kind of like shadows. And then I put in the mountains. Then I had the colours going in a gradient, so like darker at the top and then lighter closer it gets to the sun. And then I added in pen at the end just to give the mountains more definition, and the sun and then the trees and this little telephone pole here. So the second painting I created is just like a morning scene, so I added in the clouds here, just kind of like a purple stormy kind of vibe with the blue. And then I added in the white for the clouds and then the little birds at the end. Telephone pole as well, and then it had the blue here as well, and another gradient, kind of lighter colours coming down here. And then the third painting I created is with the trees in the middle, so I have the sky kind of dark at the top, and then like the pink coming here, and then the white behind it show kind of like clouds, and then these little pink dots look a bit like flowers. And then in the end I added in this pen, so telephone line here. And then I connected all three of them together with this telephone phone line. I think it came out pretty effective. The second piece I created is this painting. So it's just basically canvas. And then I painted over it using acrylics. So I added in the yellows and the whites and the blues, and then the tree here with the leaves on the edge. And then I went back in and I added in pen. And then the pen here just gave more definition to the tree itself. And these little wispy bits give like leaves. Then a bit of a shadow here in the blue. And then I went over and added white and yellow dots in it, just to make it kind of more like a dreamy midsummer's evening. And then the third painting I created is this one. So this is the painting I created about a week ago. This is just also canvas as well and acrylic. So I wanted to do like a poppy scene. So first of all, I added in the sky, like these blues and the yellows. And the whites, and then I wanted to have the grass in it with the greens to echo the sky as well. I didn't want it to be too, I wanted the definite between the sky and the grass, so the grass would stand out as much. And then the poppies here, just little red dots, and the black in the middle to give them more like a poppy kind of shape.
and then I added in the lake here just to break it up a bit from the sky and add more blue in it, make it all kind of contrast together. And then I added in these trees here, so that's just done using sponge, just a green paint and then sponge all together. And then these little branches here and some more poppies. So this is my four piece that I created. So basically I made a lino block and then I drew in my design in pencil and then I etched with an etching tool. And then I just drew in the outline of the hairs and the mushrooms and then the trees here and then the sun. And then the sun coming through the hair, so you can kind of see like the lines there just to show definition. And then I added in the trees at the back to show place. So I just want to put the hairs in the forest. And yeah, so when I think of midsummer, so I just think of like little animals and like hares and like fairies and stuff. So yeah, that's my fourth piece. So this is my last piece, which is also a lino piece. So I wanted to do another like scene, like in a forest. So I wanted to have a rose in the center and then the hills here and then have the trees in the background. I wanted the hills to be kind of rounded because I wanted them to echo the shape of the leaf of the flowers. And then I added in colors I chose were red, black, and green, and then like whatever I wanted to keep white, I cut out here in the background. So I like this piece. I think it came out quite effective and I like the colours all together. I think it's a nice contrast with the hairs as well. And here's just all my paintings together. Please feel free to follow my art account on Instagram at polyartaccount, and thank you for listening.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I work under the artist name of Sick Kitty. I'm a painter and performer, and today I'm going to share some of my work with you.
So all of these pieces are oil on canvas. They all explore the theme of reincarnation. They're quite emotional pieces, and they show a transition from, I guess, darkness into probably more colourful and healthier space. Nature is a big theme in my work, and I guess for me, if I'm surrounded by a lot of death or grief, I find nature and just seeing things growing is a good medicine for that. This is the first piece, Seedling. It's oil and mixed media on canvas, and it's €400. Again, this next piece is oil on canvas. This piece is called Guardian and it's €300. For me, I wasn't exactly sure what this creature is. It just sort of appeared to me as I was painting in my mind. It's a protector of the environment that it lives in. Above this piece is Wasteland. This piece is €200, and again it shows my interest in nature, the destruction and corruption in nature, and I guess for me it's like a toxic environment. This piece is titled Unknown. It's €500. I guess for me, I was sort of in a very liminal space where I was beginning to emerge from this darkness. There's still a lot of frustration in the mark making, but then there's also this really nice, clean. Clean space, which is more dreamlike and lighter. The final piece is Rose, and it was based off of my dog who had to be put down last year. A dog I had for I think 16 years, and I had a dream that she had been reincarnated, which sort of set this project off. And I just really like the idea of something else kind of growing from her life. And I guess this piece is one of the more colourful ones, which for me shows the transition of me kind of dealing with my own grief and just emerging from that darkness and just growing in a new way. So again, here's all the pieces together. And yeah, thanks very much for watching.
Hi, my name's Rebecca. I'm a visual artist creating dark and atmospheric paintings in oils. And I live in Leash in the Midlands of Ireland, so you can come meet my neighbours. Here they are, there's Betsy and Daisy. There's Big Uncle Billy. Over there we got bovine specimen number 3204. And there's little old Margaret. Okay, so the first piece that I want to show you is one that I started at the beginning of lockdown, but then quickly abandoned it in favour of doing other things like freaking out about the virus and learning to do the splits. I've started working on it again the past few days, so, and it's almost there, it just needs some tidying up a bit. It's still a bit messy in parts. It's called Lucifer's Nest, and it's about when something or someone is bad for you, but it makes you feel safe by making itself at home in you. Let me just give you a close-up of that juicy eyeball up there. A nice demon hand. When it's done, it'll be €400, and it's oil on canvas, 100 by 70 centimeters. This next piece is called Consented Constraints. This piece explores the archetype of the lover, in particular the shadow side, so vulnerability, the balance between giving and receiving, and unhealthy bonds. It's like super shiny, I don't know if you can see it. I really love painting the hair on this one and just tackling the weird angle and just trying to get it right. It's really satisfying when you can get something like that right. It's 60 by 80 centimeters, and it's oil on board, and it costs €380. This next piece that I want to show you is called Sacrificial Wounds, and it's a special one to me because there was a lot of synchronicity behind its conception. This painting is based on the mother archetype, and it explores the unconditional love and support between mother and daughter, but also the remorse and sacrifice and responsibility that can also come with that. My friend Debbie, who is a life model, posed as the maternal figure, and my sister posed as the daughter. And we also had a special guest model in here for the bump. There he is, man of the hour. Anyway, this piece is 120 by 90 centimeters. It's the biggest painting that I have at the moment, and it is 430 euro. Okay, so this next piece isn't actually for sale, but it didn't feel right showing the others and then leaving this one out, so I'll just show you her really quickly. This piece is called Lunar Empress, and it explores the archetype of the queen. It's all about confronting and conquering aspects of our shadow. It's oil on canvas again. This next piece that I want to show you is called Reckless Dark Desires, and it's all about lust and control and manipulation. All my figures are usually situated in some sort of ethereal realm, like a void or something. They're all a representation of aspects of our subconscious, so they're just kind of out there existing in this like metaphysical plane. If that makes any sense. This piece is oil on canvas, and it's 100 by 70 centimeters, and the cost is 300 euro. My last piece that I want to show you is called Self-Destructive Dance. It's basically about surrendering to your shadow, reveling in it, and allowing that darkness to take the reins for a while. This piece is 50 by 70 centimeters, and the price is 200 euro. Thank you for watching, and if you're interested in any of my paintings, please do get in touch. And thanks to Doreen for organizing this for me, and to all the artists for taking part as well. Thank you, bye bye.
And that's it for our virtual exhibition. We would like to thank all the wonderful artists who participated, and to thank you for watching and supporting us as we find new ways to exhibit our work. We've enjoyed it so much that we aim to make this a yearly exhibition. Thank you again, and have a beautiful Midsummer's.